She was dodging her conscience. Playing fetch with the mind was simple, but the idea of living with someone she wasn't quite sure she loved for the rest of her life seemed far-fetched. I knew she wanted to say no, but her lips let out otherwise. See, April was 26 in the blue dress the night she stretched out her finger for a jewel of promise of a marriage worthwhile. Cause see, she'd rather be engaged to a man that made her feel good about herself momentarily than to be engaged in a conversation with her parents about when she was getting married and when they were gonna have grandkids. See, to April, every day is May Day. I miss a society where everyone around her is posting pictures of 2 feet high wedding cakes with 4, 5, 6 bridesmaids. Preachers speaking more of getting married and less of why marry. And every time the sentence, "you are getting older," strikes a fear in her heart Zeus has nothing to do with. So because of her stormy seas, she rocks the boat Jesus isn't on. And goes with what, after all, society says is acceptable. Kwame is smart and rich and cute. But darling, if marriage was about that, then your child's father will be a Bill Gates turned Easter Bunny. See, this wasn't funny when she slipped into a white dress conspicuous enough the galaxy would recognize and stood opposite and adjacent to her groom and reverend, said I do, so the pressure subdued. At least for the moment. See, everyone thought she had done it too. They were happy. But those who knew not what she was going through thought she fit the glass slipper. They thought she was lucky. How can you be weird? And your guests are happier than you are. It's like you are being fed, and Oliver is no hungrier than you are. You want more. Flower petals in the air, confetti on the floor. But 2 years later, Kwame is barely home. Your friend said the scene with the secretary, and you are standing in the nursery holding Kwame Boateng Jr. You are crying. But no, not for yourself. But because your seed fell in the wrong Eden, even Eve won't choose to raise an able child. Like James, he is born into a family. Mommy isn't happy with daddy, and the only reason why you are stuck as a housewife, dreams unreachable, and the weight to a stern look on his face each and every morning is because of baby. Your baby. Ignorance is bliss, but misses the signs couldn't be missed. See, we've allowed people to choose for us almost everything in our lives, including our life partners. See, we've given our gifts of free will to people willing to pay a dime. See, 2/3 of families are broken because mothers are pressured, fathers are forced, children are watching, and hope is lost. Before you think about church bells ringing and flower petals falling, ask yourself, after the confetti, what next? Accept the rain because you choose to, because you are ready. Kayo yake potendo kombi. Actually.